Hello, this is Noseman from the Maxon training team, and in today's quick tip, I'm going to show you how to solve the following problem. I have these three sets of three different objects. I have three different flowers, and three different vases, and three different tables. Yes, these are tables in my world. Don't judge me. I want to create combinations of these random combinations, a vase with a random table and a random flower, but I want to be able to control them with my own randomness, but in unison. I want to create essentially this effect over here, where the combination of vase, flower, and table is random. I can change that randomness by changing any of a number of random seeds. You can see that the tables now are randomizing, or the vases are randomizing, or the flowers are randomizing. But at the same time, I want to be able to select something and move them around all together, or scale them, or rotate them, or do whatever I want. So let me show you how you can set this up. You may be inclined to start with a cloner and use this cloner in object mode. There you go, object mode. Drag your cloning surface. Let's take this source over here, drag it in here, and put, let's say, the three tables. So torus, cube, and cylinder underneath here, and then do the same thing with the others. But we are not going to do that. I'm going to move this down because we are going to use it in some sort of way. What I am going to do, and I'm going to turn it off temporarily, is create a matrix object. And I'm going to use this matrix object in object mode, and I'm going to drag my cloner source in this matrix. From this point onwards, instead of cloning on the sphere itself, I am going to clone on the matrix. So let me turn this back on, and instead of the sphere clone source, I'm going to drag in here the matrix. And you will see that we are going to get the tables in the same positions. And I can always make this matrix invisible. Let's do the same thing. I'm going to make a copy of this cloner, delete everything underneath it, and get the three vases and drop them under here. Make a copy of this cloner, delete the vases now, and put the flowers underneath. And they're all cloning on the same surface. The great thing at this point is that I can take the matrix and go and move them around so that they're aligned exactly where I want them to be. And it should be minus 90 in this particular case. And now I can just go and change the number of clones or anything else I want. And I can add any random permutations to each and every one of these cloners. I haven't named them here, but that's not a problem. I'm going to add a random effector to the first one, so random. I'm going to make sure that the parameters are off and the modify clone is on. And I'm going to do the same for the rest of my cloners. Put that there, make a copy here, attach it to the effector here, and then do the same here, make a copy, select this and attach it over here. Now, by changing the random seed alone in each of my effectors, I can change the tables, or I can change the vases, or I can change the flowers. And you can increase the complexity by adding more vases, more flowers, or more tables, or anything else you want. If you enjoy our quick tips, please like, comment, subscribe, and enable notifications so you never miss another quick tip.